Hey guys, welcome to Dragon Age Inquisition. I am back at Skyfall for the moment, because I just check in between recording sessions generally, but I noticed there's actually a quest marker on the throne right now, which is certainly a change of pace. Also, this whole place already looks better. It was all full of horrifying debris and was awful before, but hey, now it's all cleaned up. It's nice. Let's see what happens when I sit on this throne then. It says I'm gonna judge a prisoner.
Impressive, is it not? Fit for a leader, meant to show influence and the burden of it. It is where the Inquisition will sit in judgment, where you will sit in judgment.
Who will I be judging exactly?
Those who have done wrong. You will know of them, at the very least. All this presumes they have survived their initial encounter with you, of course.
Do I really need to oversee even more death? I'm nearly at capacity.
I share your distaste for more bloodshed, but it needn't come to that. The Inquisition's sovereignty is derived from the allies who validate it. You are both empowered and bound. Justice has many tools. If their application is clever, execution may even seem merciful by comparison.
Is there anyone I should judge?
Take the throne when you're ready. We will bring him before you.
I guess I'll press sit again.
You recall Geryon Alexius of De Winter. Ferelden has given him to us as an acknowledgement of your aid. The formal charges are apostasy, attempted enslavement, and attempted assassination on your own life, no less. De Winter has disowned and stripped him of his rank. You may judge the former Magister as you see fit.
I remember what would have happened to Thedas if his treachery had succeeded.
I couldn't save my son. Do you think my fate matters to me?
Will you offer nothing more in your defense?
You've won nothing. The people you saved, the acclaim you've gathered. You'll lose it all in the storm to come. Render your judgment, Inquisitor.
Your magic was theoretically impossible, Alexius. I could use people like you. Your sentence is to serve, under guard, as a researcher on all things magical for the Inquisition.
No execution? Very well.
Alrighty. I do try to be reasonable in all this because justice is one thing and it's fun to go one way or another for that, but hey, I'm all for looking for more resources with which to further our progress with the Inquisition as a whole. That's how we succeed here, right? I want to check in with a few people. Got confused for a second there. Well, there's different floors to check out. I want to check in on Sarah and Cassandra while we're in town. I think that's going to be my goal today. Whenever I come into town, it's always good to check in with a couple party members just to progress storylines, because we're supposed to be going back and forth between the storylines and the outer world stuff whenever we get a chance. So I'll talk to a couple characters, we'll do our little missions we send people out for, and then I'll get back to doing Hawk's mission, which we're about ready to start in earnest now that I've cleared out a lot of the preliminary stuff in the area along the way. Where is Sarah now? Did they move everyone around again? There's Cassandra.
He's out of his mind.
Something is troubling me, Inquisitor. Liliana is receiving reports of mages becoming possessed. Templars going rogue. No one is dealing with these matters. I was hoping we might, before they get worse.
We can certainly look into it.
I will mark these incidents on the map as I learn of them, Inquisitor. And I would be pleased to accompany you if and when you investigate.
Do you have any advice for me?
Tell that demon. What does it call itself? Cole. Tell it to leave. He may not mean harm, but that does not mean he will not harm us. Spirits are not creatures to take at face value. Be cautious with him, Inquisitor.
I have some more questions.
Why am I not surprised?
Tell me about your brother.
I'd rather not.
I'll let you get back to work.
One of these days, we'll get more from him. Unfinished business. Take down Leon and Lucien? Oh. That went away very quickly, but what is that? Oh, Jesus. How do I even find that? Oh, no. Oh, unfinished business. There we go. So that's Cassandra's new quest. Western Approach, Empress Dilan. So we're just supposed to take down a whole bunch of people, preferably with Cassandra in the party, just like how our friend Blackwall wants to accompany us when we collect these Grey Warden artifacts. I may specifically clear out areas with a normal party and then go for these specific objectives with these party members sometime. It's a little awkward because these guys are, they're both spec'd as tanks. In particular, they're both melee warriors when I'm already a melee warrior. So fitting them into a party can be awkward. Where is Sarah? I want to talk to her next, but she must be up in this building somewhere. They seem to be moving around characters when I'm not around, and it makes it a little hard to find them all. Oh, there's a our rogue scout. Ooh, what's that say? Ooh, I'm jumping again. Herald's Rest, a place for all in service here to rest, regroup, and persevere. Though ways the heart remembers best, your saving grace, the Herald's Rest. That's a nice little slogan. Oh, there's more to read in here. I'll pass for now, but we'll get to some of these notes in the future. They're just kind of around, aren't they? There's an Iron Ball's lackey right there. Sarah's up here?
I hope I can help somehow.
You're not
Maybe
Sarah.
Cleaning?
You're not Sarah at all. There's a third floor. They're just making it increasingly inconvenient to get to all these characters, aren't they? Ooh. Wait, Cole is here. Oh, Cole is here. Where is Sarah? Sarah's on the same floor as Iron Bull. Fuck it, I'm right next to Cole. Let's just talk to Cole. I'm back outside?
What are you doing?
Listening. Eyes rough, jangling armor hurts my ears, back aching, fingers too clumsy for knots. Wind cool like Aunt Eloise's pond, lips scalded as I sip, warmth blossoms, first kiss in the barn, what was his name? Tin jangle as the blood spills, Pierre's wrapped body on the wagon to the chantry, 5 more minutes, my fault.
Can you listen to anyone's mind like you did hers?
No, they have to need me. Pain, fear, sadness, guilt, anger, hurt. Things I can fix.
Can you do something for her?
Yes. It's okay. Nothing you did mattered.
What? Who are you?
They lie there, and sometimes they die, just like Pierre. You can't save them.
I don't know who you are.
Wait. That didn't work. Let me try again. You'll forget me in a minute. You can't save all of them.
What?
Like Pierre getting sick after you snuck out to Aunt Eloise's pond. You want it to be your fault, so there's a reason and it's not so frightening. But there is no reason. Pierre just got sick. The soldier was never going to live. It wasn't your fault. Better.
So you walk into their lives, make them feel better, and they just forget you.
Yes. It's better to help and then be gone. If I stay, it can be frightening.
For you or for them?
Yes. Thank you for letting me help her. It's not how a person would do it. But it helped. That's what matters.
That's actually really interesting to have Cole around and have him just be hopping into people's heads. And I guess for when you think about it, Cole's presence here is actually improving morale pretty consistently. And that's definitely a good spot to be in. So I think Cassandra may be wrong about him. And I think he's helping the group as a whole on a regular basis in ways that we don't understand because we can't see it. But anyway, we had a little moment with Cole and Cassandra. I'll be sure to talk to people regularly as we progress, but this game's going to be like 50 years long, so I'm sure I can space it out just fine. I'm going to walk back to the war room, and we're going to, oops, went to the quarters on accident. I'll see you guys when I get to the war room. Alrighty, welcome back, Warcans. Oh, right, I have another point to spend. Okay, well, forced as it is, still trying to get that, more heal. Ooh, increases the maximum number of potions the party can carry by 4. I have access to it now. Did Lord Baran count as a point? He must have, because I only have these two skills. That's the dumb writing skill. True Grit is... all party members gain 10% increase to all defenses. That's kind of fucking awesome also. I'm going to have to buy that next time I get a chance too, but I think I'm going to go for more healing potions because that seems pretty awesome to have. Let's go for that. There we go. Mission accomplished. So apparently getting that extra agent actually managed to... That extra agent counted as a point and made it easier to buy the next thing. So that brings new meaning for the a magister in disgrace. There we go. So apparently Alexius is helping Leliana, which means that let's see. Yeah, nothing says it requires 3 points. So only stuff that requires 4 points. It looks like okay. So all these agents I'm getting are actually going to make it easier for me to get better skills in general. For various parts of the Inquisition, even if I don't have points in advance. That's good to know. Okay, good. So let's see where we left off. Oh my god, there's a lot of marks on this map. First of all, let's look for exclamation points, because those are completed ones, so let's wrap up the ones we already have.
The city has agreed to send us 5 dozen guardsmen.
Not raw recruits. With luck, they'll know which end to grip a sword by.
Shadows over Denerim. Inquisitor. Well, that was bracing. A pitched battle with evil mages disguised as kitchen servants. Fireballs flying and swords flashing. It brings back old times. I won't be eating anything coming out of those kitchens for a while, let me tell you. I wonder if they were going to poison me. Nasty little cultists. Anyway, I'm grateful for the Inquisition's help. We won't have found them without you, King Alistair Therain. Ferelden Medallion of Service, which is another trinket. And hey, 60 influence. Not bad. I really wish Alistair had a more prominent role in this game, because I really loved his writing in the first game, but hey, maybe there's still time, maybe he can show up. What the fuck? There's so many icons on this map. Okay, let's just make a dent in this shit. Reclaiming the Mage Rebellion. Commander, a lot of mages just showed up. I hope they're friendlies, because if they're not, we're in trouble. Captain Rylan. Enhanced amulet of magic. That means it'll be better than my current magic amulets. That's good to know. Oh, there's one over here. I have to really search for them because there's so many. So here's Dorian's request. Dorian's leads were effective. The Inquisition found several locations where these Venatori could be hiding. Advanced camps, purpose unknown. If you wish to deal with these mages, I'm certain Dorian would be pleased. I'll mark the locations on your map should you pass by any in your travels. Oh, so I think we just unlocked Dorian's companion quest too. So we're starting to rack some of those up. Good to know because Dorian's already a part of my party half the time. So let's see here. I'm trying to remember which location is the one I'm currently in. Jesus Christ, they're so dense. Okay, find the warden. This is where I am right now in the story. So let's do some... Let's send people to do on scouting missions that are actually related to my current location. Gather herbs, expose the double agent. Right, we found out about a double agent when we captured the keep and found out that someone's working against us. That's good to do. To serve any master. There we go. Find Crestwood's mayor. That's going to be a priority. Because he needs to answer for his sins. I understand that he did what he did to try to help people, because he tried to stop the Darkspawn sickness, but he drowned his own people. That's disgusting. That's pretty horrible. And I don't think all of them were sick either. So like, he just decided to mass slaughter people because some of them were sick. The mayor of Crestwood left a letter confessing that he was the one who flooded the village 10 years ago. Then he disappeared. The Inquisition must track him down if he's to serve justice. So we'll probably have to sit at the throne and decide what to do with him. Cullen, we already have soldiers on the road in that area. Well, they'll hunt down the mayor. You do that, Cullen. Bring the Lord's justice upon him and stuff like that, I guess. Let's see. Escape routes for agents in Crestwood. That's definitely relevant. Inquisitor, I have moved some of my agents into Caer Bonash, the fortress in Crestwood. At the moment, the villagers prefer us to the bandits, and it is an excellent waypoint from Ferelden to Arlay. We can make a rendezvous point for our messengers carrying sensitive information from either country. You're familiar with the caves underneath Crestwood. They run for miles, and if we excavate some passages, our agents could easily enter and exit the keep without being seen. Leliana. Well, Leliana, you go ahead and do that mission yourself then. And you're actually the best for it anyway. But yeah, Leliana, go ahead and do your own mission. She says, opening these secret tunnels will let us evade any prying eyes that turn towards Caer Bonash. Go for it.
Let's see what we have.
I like that these are actually directly related to what I'm doing in the area too, because a lot of the quests have been kind of random stuff that are just related to certain characters I know. These are directly related to stuff that I'm doing on site. Okay, so no one can do the double agent. That's probably a Leliana quest, so she can't do that now. You can gather herbs, but I'll do repeatable quests later. To serve any of it, master versus Crestwood resources. Let's do to serve any master because that sounds interesting. Inquisitor, here's an interesting thing. Among the various things we found at Caer Bonash that belonged to its former merchant inhabitants was a journal, and in it I found mention of several high-placed clerks in the Imperial Counting Office who are, shall we say, known for their loose tongues. They sell what they know to mercenaries seeking to outbid others for work. But should we dispatch agents to speak with them, it would be very little pressure to have them work exclusively for us. The agents would need to remain to watch over the new friends, but I've been trying to place eyes on these positions for years. Leliana. Oh wow, Josephine's actually good for the job too. What a coincidence, she's also the person that's left. Josephine, with your permission, I'll send agents to secure these men straight away. You go for it, Josephine. I think we're in a good position right now. Alright, so all three agents are out, and they're all doing stuff related to the location we're working in. I'm gonna go ahead and do the Find the Warden quest. Let's head right in there. I think I might bring Vivian with us, because people keep talking about Vivian's crazy her specialization class. And I'm noticing only the companions I've taken into battle since the story happened have actually gotten their specialization. So maybe if I bring someone else in, I'll gain access to that. Maybe. Alright, so I was right about Vivian. You bring her into the battle and she immediately unlocks her new tree, which is Knight Enchanter, which people have flipped out about over and over again. Whether it's high fashion or the battlefield, Vivian prefers to be at the forefront and in control of everything around her. She will personally see order restored by the blade if necessary. So this tree gives her some crazy barrier abilities, basically. First off, she has Spirit Blade. It's basically, she summons like a magic weapon and she just starts meleeing people. So essentially she becomes a new melee fighter, which is certainly different from Mage. I guess this is kind of the replacement for the Arcane Warrior from Dragon Age Origins. Combat Clarity. Basically, when she has enemies nearby, she gets 50% bonus regeneration. Also, notably, this gives her Constitution, despite being a mage. So she's actually going to have more hit points, which is different. Fade Cloak. It's just an ability that makes her temporarily invincible, and she can use it fairly frequently, but this upgrade makes it so she does 10 times weapon damage when she makes contact with someone, which is crazy. Her special ability is that she can revive and heal everyone in an area. Fade Shield is the main thing about being a Knight Enchanter, as far as I can tell, which is that all damage she does, and this is a passive, by the way, not an active ability, it's a passive ability that makes it so that all damage she ever does gives her 30% of that damage back in the form of a barrier. So if she hurts anything, she generates barrier just all the time, which is nuts. Also, 3 magic. I invested in other trees a little bit. I went for barrier and guardian spirit, so she can cast barrier herself if she wants to, and she can also use guardian spirit, which is when she's about to die, she self barriers, which is funny because then she'll go back to having a barrier which she can then maintain by doing more damage, and basically completely turn around the part where she's about to die. I also invested points into the lightning tree, who gave her energy barrage. I mean, energy barrage, which is a nice a detonation ability that she could use. Gave her conductive current, which makes her do more damage whenever she has less mana. And it gave her static charge, which makes her just do damage to people around her when she's casting spells if they try to attack her and interrupt her. So basically, I gave her... like, this should help her generate barrier even more because she'll be doing more damage for all of her missing mana, which sounds like it'd be pretty powerful. And the static charge will do AoE damage. I mean, not AoE damage, but it'll hurt anyone who's really engaging her in combat while she's trying to cast stuff in general. So basically just more ways to keep her barrier going forever. And of course, I went with Fade Step, and I did the upgrade for Fade Step, where when you pass through people, it does damage. My plan being, whenever I start a fight, I can use Fade Step with Vivian to charge directly through them and immediately start the fight. Not only with her closing into melee range to fight properly, but she's also immediately does damage to them through Frost Step, which causes her to generate barrier immediately. I'm not entirely sure, but I think I'm going to go ahead and just say to not have a mana reserve for this character and let her fight on her own and just let her do what she wants. I'm going to go ahead and turn up the healing potion reserve for her. Right, I was put it for all like I do with all my casters because they have Guardian Spirit. But I'm gonna let her do whatever she wants with her magic. Her primary offensive ability is a blade that only costs 10 magic, so she can use it all the time. And every attack gives her more barrier, and her being low on magic actually makes her stronger. So she'll probably be on autopilot a lot, or I might take control of her to have some fun with her. But I think she's going to be the one character that I actually want to be constantly using up all of her energy abilities. So we'll see how this works out. It'll definitely be a change of pace. I might regret having Solas in the party now, though. So maybe I want to go swap him out for someone else. Maybe. I might... no, I'll keep Solas around for the manual barrier. Solas will keep everyone else alive. If I feel like I'm not doing enough damage, I can always back out to switch him for someone else. But for now, I think I'm about ready to start out the next area. And Cullen's already back from his mission because I spent so much time customizing that character real quick. But I'm not going to go back for that yet. I'm going to very quickly do a... let's do a new save. I always clean up saves later so they're not stacking up infinitely. And we're going to check out... wait, where was the next... right, we have to go down to the camp down here because we're going to finally check out what the hell Hawk's quest was. And hopefully this party composition works out, and I don't regret this. It kind of looks like I'm supposed to just run up this hill over here to get where I'm going. So let's see how this goes. Maybe I can get in a few minor skirmishes along the way to generate a little guard for Vasti, who, frankly, I will admit has less efficient ways of generating protection than Vivian does now. I don't know. I don't think I'm going to be able to get up around here. I might have to go all the way around. Yeah, we'll find out. This looks a little promising. Alright. Come on, Vasti. Hardcore parkour! Okay, there's an invisible wall here. There goes that plan. There's probably no level over there, actually. So, do I have to go... I don't know what route I'm supposed to take from here, then. Let's see here. Oh! You sliding around a little, Vivian? There we go. If we go down here, it might be possible that we can circumvent the hill in this direction. Otherwise, we might have to backtrack over by the, it'd be unfortunate to have to backtrack over towards that Astrarium, although I guess we'd get an Astrarium out of the deal, but be a little confused. The downside of having a new, skill tree unlocked this late in the game... alright, this looks new. Yeah, this looks promising, okay.
Warden ally should be inside that cave.
The downside of having a new tree like this to look at is that I look at the skills in the bottom corner, and I'm like, well, I recognize barrier, I guess. And I'm just sort of confused looking at them. I'm like, what do these buttons do? So this one makes me invisible for a second. I mean, invincible for a second. And if I materialize in someone, they do damage. What's the blade look like? Wow, I just straight up slash at people? So she just does magic sword combos. And presumably, if she hits an enemy with that, it'll cost 10 mana. And of course, energy barrage.
What is that horrendous
smell? Oh shit! I guess we're fighting him now. That was unintentional.
Where is it coming from?
Oh well.
Nowhere.
Ow! Holy shit, I just obliterated... What the fuck? What the f... Everyone's dying! Oh my god, Druffalos are no joke! What the fuck? First of all, what the... Okay, let's just... I'll keep you alive, Vasty, it's cool. I was not prepared for this to go bad like this. I'm invisible and I'm inside you, that means you get hurt a lot when I come back, right? Maybe? I don't know. That was... I was not expecting this to get bad so fast. Charge! Yeah, you're all cold now. How's that feel? They're materialized inside of him? Well, at least I'm getting barrier, I guess. Holy shit. Druffalo are no joke, by the way. I'm gonna have to go back to camp to regenerate from that. That was a mistake. Yeah, so, the only reason... Sarah got one shot. Vasty's tankier than that. But, Vivian and Solas both... only survived because they have Guardian Spirit bringing their health back. What the fuck? What are these enemies? Oh, it's just wolves. Okay. I guess I have to fight them now because we're in combat, apparently. Oh well. Hey, wolves. You guys have fun fighting that, that Druffalo? Now you're all icy. Oh, did I just aggro the Druffalo by doing that? I may have just aggroed the Druffalo. Whoopsie. Well, now I definitely aggroed the Druffalo. I just accidentally targeted him with that spell. Let's keep Vasty up for sure. Okay. And Fade Cloak. Oh, that was just a poorly aimed Fade Cloak. It's a little hard to aim Fade Cloak. The whole point is to be able to materialize inside someone for a bunch of damage, I think. But it's a little hard to aim it because you're invisible. Like, very invisible. Just keep smacking people for more bonus guard, I guess? I mean, more bonus barrier? We can cast barrier for Vasty real quick. And barrage! I mean, I definitely have a lot of barrier, so that seems to be working in that aspect at the very least. Yeah. This build might work out for us. It's gonna take some getting used to. It's a really weird feeling. I don't think I like... I'm not sure if I like controlling her so much as just... It'll be probably just fun to watch her fight in general as part of the fight. But I'll be right back. I'm gonna go undo my mistake that lost all that health. Yeah, let's go back to camp. Alright, after that silly little mishap, we're much more prepared to take on this quest in earnest. Oh, is that Hawk? Was Hawk just standing here watching us embarrass ourselves? Because that's kind of a bummer. Is he?
Glad you made it. I just got here myself. My contact with the wardens should be at the back of the cave.
There was a group of wardens out there hunting a senior warden. They said he was a traitor.
Of course they did. They may even have believed it. How much blood is shed by good men following bad orders?
Huh. I gotta say, Maya Hawk was a two-dagger rogue. He was not a bow rogue, but that kind of information isn't really included in Dragon's Keep, unfortunately. Is there anything else to talk to him about?
Let's go.
Nope, not really. Okay. Is he gonna be along for the ride to help out? Looks like it. Alright, Deep Mushroom. We'll just pick up whatever's here along the way and wail on people. It's going to be nice having access to this nice, hearty amount of 12 potions. Holy shit. That is not an insignificant change. That is not an insignificant change in potions. 50% in boost to one of the most vital resources in the entire game. See how this goes.
It's just us. I brought the Inquisitor.
My name is Stroud, and I'm at your service, Inquisitor.
I'll take all the help I can get. I know the Wardens have troubles of their own. I wonder, though, might those troubles have anything to do with Corypheus?
I fear it is so. When my friend Hawk slew Corypheus, Weishaupt was happy to put the matter to rest. But an archdemon can survive wounds that seem fatal, and I feared Corypheus might possess the same power. My investigation uncovered clues, but no proof. Then, not long after, every warden in Orlais began to hear the calling.
Maker! Why didn't you tell me?
It was a Grey Warden matter. I was bound by an oath of secrecy.
Is the calling some sort of Grey Warden ritual?
The calling tells a warden that the Blight will soon claim him. Starts with dreams. Then come whispers in his head. The warden says his farewells and goes to the deep roads to meet his death in combat.
And every Grey Warden in Orlais is hearing that right now. They think they're dying.
Yes. Likely because of Corypheus. If the Wardens fall, who will stand against the next Blight? It is our greatest fear.
So Corypheus isn't controlling them. He's bluffing them with this calling. And they're falling for it.
Is the calling they're hearing real? Or is Corypheus mimicking it somehow?
I know not. Even as a senior warden, I had heard only the vaguest whispers of Corypheus. The wardens believe that this calling is real, and they will act accordingly. That is all we know for certain.
You said all the wardens are hearing the calling. Does that include you?
Sadly, yes. It lurks like a wolf in the shadows around a campfire. The creature that makes this music has never known the love of the Maker, but at times, I almost understand it. We must uncover what Corypheus has done and end it. This cannot stand.
How can Corypheus make all these wardens hear the calling?
I cannot say. We know little about him, save that he is dangerous. He is a magister, as well as a darkspawn, and speaks with the voice of the Blight. That lets him affect the minds of wardens, since we are tied to the Blight ourselves. It must be how he created this false calling.
So the wardens think they're dying and have stopped thinking clearly. That won't go well.
We are the only ones who can slay archdemons. Without us, the next Blight will consume the world. Warden Commander Clarel spoke of a blood magic ritual to prevent future Blights before we all perished. When I protested the plan as madness, my own comrades turned on me. Grey Wardens are gathering here, in the Western Approach. It is an ancient Tevinter ritual tower. Meet me there, and we will find answers.
Let's go.
Okay, so, Mr. Hawk, you knew we were going to walk into this chamber with the warden in it, and he was going to be on his guard because he's being hunted, and yet you let me go first with such a big gap that the guy is going to be, like, on the verge of attacking me because you wouldn't just... Like, why did you go first? He knows who you are, you silly, silly man that I controlled for an entire game. Regarding the calling, so many refuse to speak of it, but how can we know it? How can we identify it if we do not share it? The calling is not a source of shame. The song that whispers in the back of our mind is no evil upon my soul, but the mark of a life well lived in service of a greater good. If all things come from the Maker, then is this too not part of his plan? Could it not be a gift, a final haunting melody to send us into the afterlife with our hearts opened? Could this not be his song? It scratches at my thoughts, the music almost a voice. At once unearthly and beautiful, I found myself humming it aloud a few days past, where once it intruded. It now feels a natural part of my mind's course. It coils around memories I hold dear, training with Sir Keller, riding in the moonlight, my mother's face the last time I saw her. It inserts itself into them, so that I could almost swear that music, that sense of a presence watching and calling, had always been a part of what I remember. This is what the senior wardens warned us of, I imagine. I should not find it beautiful. I must remember that corruption and recognize that my mind is slowly losing the way to differentiate between this world and that which would consume and destroy it. I must. I can. I will tell the wardens tomorrow. I have seen their looks. They already know, I suspect. I will heed the calling and go to the deep roads to die with the dwarves, fighting as a Grey Warden should. But if I am to die, after all I have given, can I not at least allow myself pleasure of the song's beauty? The final pages of My Fellow Wardens by Sir Marjorie Baron. So one note to make here is Stroud. I'm not entirely sure, but I think in the Legacy DLC, you choose between Stroud and another person. Like, you have to side with one of two Grey Wardens, I think. And I think whoever you don't side with, I think, dies? Or maybe I'm thinking of someone else, but, I actually read the wiki recently about, not the whole page, but, like, some of the Dark Souls, the Dragon Age 2 related stuff about who we're fighting, Corypheus. And you choose, in that quest, you choose between two Grey Wardens to help, like, which one you decided with in that confrontation, and one of them...
I heard what he said. Hopefully we'll find some answers in the Western approach, though I fear what those answers will be. I've seen too much blood magic to ever trust where it leads.
What happens is one of them actually ends up getting, what am I trying to say? One of them gets, possessed by Corypheus, seemingly, and that's why he's back now. That's the explanation for his return. Banner of the Blind Man. This banner marks the cave as an outpost of the Blind Men, notorious smugglers who are known to sell slaves to Deventer. It is possible that the Grey Warden asked them to politely leave so that he could use their hideout, although the bloodstains on the wall suggest otherwise. That's actually pretty funny. Come to think of it, I think you meet two Grey Wardens, one of them dies, and the other one gets possessed by Corypheus, so I guess Stroud isn't either of them. He must be from some... I feel like I know him from something else, but I don't think he is that character. So I might have to look up where Stroud is from, if he's from anything. At this point, practically everyone you meet in these games is from another game at some point. But anyway, is that really it? That appears to be it, surprisingly. We came to this location just to meet with that dude, and now it wants us to go somewhere else, right? Here lies the abyss. It wants us to go to the Western approach now. Wow, okay. We literally just... I mean, I'm happy I did a bunch of other quests along the way, so it's fine, but we just came to Crestwood so that we could meet one guy in a cave and then leave. Oh, well.